when Jesus Christ was on the cross, he cried, "My Lord, my God, why have you forsaken me?"
Okay, now I understand. I understand.
Okay, let me say this. Because Jesus, the Bible said he became sin for us. He became sin.
Yeah, Biblia nasema Yesu aligeuka dhambi kwetu.
He took all the sins of the whole world.
Alikamata dhambi zote za dunia.
And he took the punishment of all the sins.
Alikamata hukumu ya dhambi zote.
So he was punished by God for all the sins of the whole world.
Alikuwa punishwa na Mungu kwa dhambi zote za dunia.
Now the punishment of sin is always separation from God and death.
Na matokeo ya dhambi ni hukumu ya milele na kifo.
And Jesus took that punishment.
Na Yesu alisema kuhusu ile hukumu.
So that when we sin,
kwa sababu wakati tunafanya dhambi,
God doesn't leave us right away.
Mungu hawezi kutuacha kabisa.
God continue moving our heart to move us repent.
Mungu anaendelea sisi kutuchemsha ndani ili tutubu.
And then he draw us back to him.
Na kisha mwishowe anaturejesha kwake.
If Jesus had not died for us,
kama Yesu angekufa kwa ajili yetu,
the moment we sin,
wakati tunafanya dhambi,
God can send us to hell right away.
Na Mungu anatutuma kuzimu pale pale.
Because Jesus has died for us to take away.
Kwa sababu Yesu alikufa kwa ajili yetu.
He took away the punishment.
Alitoa hukumu kwetu.
So God can continue to work in our hearts so that we can be forgiven.
Na Mungu sasa anaweza kututembelea ili sisi tusamehewe.
But if a person continues sin, he can still face eternal punishment and separation from
God. Na kama mtu anaendelea kufanya dhambi kwa kweli ataona mauti ya milele na hukumu.
So the point is this.
Na jambo ni hili.
Jesus took all the sins.
Yesu alitoa dhambi zote.
And then for us, when we are still a Christian,
na katika maisha yetu kama tunaendelea kuwa wa Kristo,
God will move in our hearts so that we continue to follow him.
Na Mungu ataendelea kuchemsha ndani yetu ili tuendelee kumgeukia yeye.
He gives us a chance.
Atupatia ile bahati.
Okay?
Yeah. We are running out of time, so.
Okay. Now, so we cannot finish this. I'm going to say the questions and then tomorrow you come for the test. Tomorrow we have the test.
Yeah, mimi nawaza tumeza malizia application tu tufanye mtihani.
So I give you the questions and the answers.
Kama uko na ile maulizo na majibu.
The reason I want to do this is so that you can learn it.
Na nimefanya hiyo kwa sababu ujifunze hiyo zaidi.
Okay?
Yeah.
Okay, the next question is.
Na ulizo la kufuata ni hivi.
Most people, now I will give you the answer first.
Watu wengi na wapata kwanza jibu kwanza.
Most people, even Christians, have the habit of accusing people.
Yeah, watu wengi hata na Wakristo wanakuwa na ile habitude ya kumshtaki watu.
People have a tendency to say, you're lazy.
Watu wanakuwa na tendency kusema, wewe ni mvivu.
You don't love God.
Haupendi Mungu.
You don't pray.
Hauombi.
You don't serve God.
Haumtumikie Mungu.
It's all pointing out the sins of people.
Unikuwa na shoka tu vilole ndani za watu.
Now we should point out the sins of people at some point.
Yes.
We should point out the sins of people at some point.
Tunaweza kustaki dhambi za wengine kwa mara fulani.
But if we do that all the time,
lakini kama tunafanya hiyo kila saa kila siku,
then we are doing the work of Satan.
Na pale tunafanya dhambi, tunafanya kazi ya shetani.
Because Satan accuses all the time.
Kwa sababu shetani anatushtaki kila saa kila dakika.
Accusation make people feel discouraged.
Kukushtaki watu inawafanya wakuwe discouraged.
They make them feel they are useless.
Wanafikiri wanakuwa hawana thamani.
It make them feel they cannot do the will of God.
Wanasikia kama hakuna kazi ambayo wanaweza kuifanya.
So the question is, so why do people like to accuse?
Na ulizo ni hii, kwa nini watu wanapenda kushitaki wengine?
Why do people have the habit of accusing?
Kwa nini watu wanakuwa na tabia mbaya ya kushitaki wengine?
Why do people always say you didn't do your job? Then we say to people you're lazy. Because people generally grow up in the law. Our thinking is shaped by the law. And then we always looking for faults of people. So the reason our people live grow up in the law. And because of our sins, so we have the thoughts of Satan. Satan's thought is to accuse people. So the reason is we have sinned. The reason why people accuse is because we have sins. We grow up in the law. We used to hearing accusations. We are used to accusing people. And what does that do to people? It makes people feel discouraged. It makes people lose hope. Okay, so this second question was, why do people accuse and what are the results of accusation? And the third question is, then how can we help people? And help ourselves. How can we help ourselves and help people? We help ourselves and people by telling ourselves and other people about the love of God. That God loved us while we were a sinner. When we sin, God moves in our heart to turn us to repentance. And then His love will motivate us to follow Him. Because He has planned to have many blessings for us. So God wants to bless every single person. So then, help us to be joyful in the Lord. And have strength in the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. How about when people have sinned?
Yes.
How about when people have sinned? When people have sinned, we don't just accuse them. We can tell them, God loves you and wants to forgive you and wants to bless your life. Do you want God's blessings to come to you? Or do you want to lose His blessings? So we guide people to repentance. So they will follow God and have the blessings of God.
Amen.
So an example is, if we have good Christian friends, and a good example is when we have good Christian friends. When we have done something wrong, they still love us and encourage us. It gives us motivation to change. But if people just accuse us
lakini watu wanaendelea kustaki,
we will lose hope,
tutapoteza matumaini.
Okay, do you agree with this?
Unakubaliana nami?
Have you been changed by someone who love you? Do people who love you change you?
Nimeuliza watu ambao wanakupenda wanaweza kubadilisha?
Or are you changed by people who accuse you?
Ama unaweza kubadilisha na watu ambao wanakushitaki, wanakushitaki?
Love? Yes.
Yes, he said that you've been changed by those who love.
Right, yeah. So you know that. So it's more important to love and guide people to repentance. We have to guide them to repentance.
Yeah, kwa kweli ni upendo ndio unaelekeza watu kwa kutubu.
And this is very, very important teaching.
Hii ni mafundisho muhimu.
It is actually from the Bible.
Hii ni ya kweli katika Biblia.
You can see how Jesus handled the sinners.
Unaweza kuona jinsi Yesu alishere dhambi.
Even Jerusalem.
Hata Jerusalem.
When he entered Jerusalem, he was crying for Jerusalem.
Oh, alikuwa akililia Jerusalem.
He said, Jerusalem, Jerusalem.
Alisema Jerusalem, Jerusalem.
You have rejected all the prophets that were sent to you.
Yeah, umemkataa wale ambao wamekutumia.
And you have killed the prophets.
Na umeua wanabii.
And I want to gather you.
Na nataka nikujenge kutie pamoja.
Like a hen want to gather chicks.
Yeah, ni kama
but you were not willing.
Lakini hawakupenda.
So Israel have rejected God for years and years.
Yeah, Israel mtupa kutupilia Mungu kwa miaka na miaka na miaka.
But still Jesus wanted to move them with his love.
Lakini Mungu alipenda aendelee kutumika kupitia upendo wake.
Instead of saying Jerusalem, Jerusalem, you have no hope.
Yeah, baada ya kusema Jerusalem, Jerusalem, hauna matumaini.
But he said, I want to gather you like a hen want to gather the chicks.
Oh, I nakwambia napenda nikutie kukusanya kama vile kuku anayokusanya vifaranga vyake.
So even though Jerusalem want to kill the prophets,
hata kama Jerusalem iliua manabii,
Jesus still loves Jerusalem and Israel.
Oh, Yesu aliendelea kupenda Jerusalem.
Right? Can you see that?
Unaweza kuona hiyo?
Okay.
Yeah,
God bless you. If you have questions, you can ask me later.
Ya Mungu awabariki kama kuna mwingine maulizo. Ya utakia uliza baadaye.
And then for those who want to stay a little bit, I can still pray for you and help you.
Na utapenda maombi waneza baki na
kuna. And help you how to keep the anointing of the Holy Spirit.
Na kupata mafuta ya Roho Mtakatifu sana.
Okay, God bless you all.